ignition.
Sweet.
That was pretty cool.
Come on, just stay away.
I'm getting gas, I'm getting gas.
Sweet.
Red hot.
And I will sit on your head.
Sweet. Ooh, that bag got my beard.
Ooh. In 3, 2, 1.
You're really gonna enjoy this one. Hi, I'm Jake Wizard 4 here at Faraday Studios, where we do Midnight Science Club, and we were invited to go to DragonCon 2020 to present some science activities. But alas, some of our activities we couldn't do inside the arena. Go figure, maybe a little safety issue. So we made videos of them instead. And I've got a really neat one today. I call it Runaway Propane Explosion. It's kind of cool. I hope you enjoy it. This tank contains extremely flammable gas, fire explosion hazard. Mm. This sounds like our kind of stuff, right?
Indeed.
Now this has a flammable hydrocarbon gas, right? And if I pull the trigger here on this torch, fires right up, that gets hot. Probably 1500, 1800 degrees, something like that. Sweet. So the gas is in here, but in order for it to burn, it requires some oxygen, right?
Yeah.
And so you'll notice at the base of this torch, there's some little holes. So as the gas rushes out of the tank and rushes by, ambient air pressure pushes air with its oxygen in there and it mixes. So by the time it gets up here, we get a nice hot flame. And a blue flame like that, a carbon flame, I mean, it's a clean flame, it's a good mix. So I thought what we could do is before we light this gas, we could fill this long plastic tube. You see, it's about 30 feet long. I'm gonna start pumping that full of gas, but I'm not gonna set it on fire. I'm gonna stick it in here. And I just want you to think, what's gonna happen when I do set this thing on? Now let me start filling it, and you think of the possibility. So I'm gonna pull the trigger, and right now I'm pumping that gas along with some air that's being mixed, and we're filling up this entire tube.
Well, there's always the possibility that it could explode from the sudden pressure mixing with the
whole pipe just blow up.
Yeah. Or at the other end of the pipe, it could slowly release, causing a flame to shoot out of the end of the pipe.
Because, you know, right where you got that held, right by your belly, I guess you are planning that it's not going to blow up.
Hopefully.
In case we have an accident, everybody say goodbye, Robert.
Bye, Robert.
Bye, Robert. See you later, RJ. In 3, 2, 1, I'm gonna pull the trigger. Oh my gosh, look at that flame. Well, did you see that?
That was pretty cool.
Let me do that again. I gotta do that again. Fill it up with gas again. Ignition. Sweet. That was sweet. Let me tell you. You got any ideas why that particular arrangement of flame occurred?
It was probably transferring through all the gas that had filled up the tube. And then the lack of oxygen caused it to move to where there was oxygen so that it can keep the flame going.
That's very good. That's close. The way I understand it, and I might be wrong. I'm sure everybody at NASA will let me know if I'm wrong. But when we first inject this with the mixture of oxygen and air, there's sufficient oxygen and air for the entire tube to burn. Then we fill it up with oxygen fuel mixture. The only thing it's lacking is a spark, right?
Yes.
So when we set a spark to it, it starts to burn. In front of the flame, the heat hasn't gotten there yet. And behind it, we are either using up all the fuel or using up enough oxygen so there's no longer a combustible mixture. So behind the flame, it's a lack of either fuel or oxygen. In front of the flame, there's not enough heat yet. If I could get the heat to travel at the same rate, the whole thing would go up. Thank goodness that it's not happening. The heat's just staying close to the flame. We have to do it one more time, don't we? We still have gas left in this tank. We're not quitting until we run, I guess so. Ignition. RJ, do you understand why DragonCon won't let us in the door with some of these things? You learn a little bit of science, sharpen your science skills while you blow things up. I can't think of anything better to do. You know what I mean? Wizard with torch. Yeah, that's sweet. That was neat. I enjoyed it. Let's give these people a hand. Let's give them a hand. There's a hand. There you go. We just gave them a hand. That was some of the best science I've seen in a while. We do those kinds of activities all the time. If you want more of them, you can find us on Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook.
Midnight Science Club. And you, by the way, you might not know this, but we even have a store online, and you can buy books. We have books and books and books. We do thousands of activities for thousands of people. So join us. And go to the store, too. Somebody give me a hand, please. I did a good job. Here it is. He just gave me a hand. Thank you very much. We're serious here, man. We're serious people doing serious science. You can believe it.